And WLKY Chopper HD has been flying over many of the hardest hit areas of that storm.
That's right. Our Drew Gardner shows us what the damage looks like from above. Drew?
When the deadly storms crossed over into Kentucky Friday night, Mayfield was one of its first stops. The downtown was particularly hard hit, but from the air, it's easy to see the damage extended across the entire community. National Guard helicopters surveyed the area Saturday as the search for survivors got underway. Their biggest challenge, digging through the decimated candle factory where dozens of victims were feared buried. Roughly 30 miles east in the land between the lakes, dozens of homes were flattened, entire swaths of trees laid on their sides. On one cul-de-sac, debris from homes scattered on the side of the cliff below. Dawson Springs also took a direct hit. Several homes were wiped from their foundations, one lifted off in one piece and set back down. Buildings that were spared suffered severe damage. Few structures, though, were left untouched. In the small town of Bremen, homes were completely shredded, cars tossed upside down, and trees snapped in half. This sidewalk leading to a home that is no longer there. People could be seen climbing over mounds of rubble, trying to salvage what's left of their belongings. From above, a clear path of destruction could be seen cutting through these Bowling Green neighborhoods. The tornado's path seeming to go for miles across the city, wiping out homes and businesses. The roof torn off this store, some store shelves inside tossed over, others left untouched. In Grayson County, the storm tossed around campers and boats at a marina supply store. The storms ripped off the roofs of several homes in Hart County while leveling others. Crews were there Sunday working to restore power. While many areas were spared the storm's wrath, at least 18 counties reported some kind of damage. Drew Gardner, WLKY News.